it out, London will hold many new friends and adventures for you.
I hope so.
So do I.
Oh, this is somebody you simply must meet. This is one of our finest artists, Basil Hallward.
That you're the please, a humble student of beauty. What do you think?
I've been in London 2 weeks now, and the only people I've met are Agatha's charitable group.
But you met me?
Of course. I didn't mean...
These parties are terribly dull, Dorian. You won't be missing anything.
I'm sure you're right.
Just thought it might be fun.
Some drinks.
Find a good husband who knows how to behave to a woman.
The only way to behave to a woman is to make love to her if she's pretty and to someone else if she's plain.
Would you excuse me?
Cigarette?
No, thank you.
No. I find a cigarette the perfect pleasure. It is exquisite and leaves one unsatisfied. You're Kelso's grandson.
Yes. Did you know him?
Met him once. It was enough to give a cheer last month when he rasped his last sour breath. One assumes you inherited the withered old goat's estate. Being a little orphan isn't all bad. An earnest young man with a beautiful nature, according to Agatha. I pictured some freckled country oaf in ghastly dress. I see, I was only half right. It could be worse. Gladys Allenby's been dressed for her 14th birthday ever since her 40th. And if Radley spent a little less time in church and a little more at his tailor's, he might not so resemble a badly bound hymn book. Are you sure you won't take a cigarette? I get them directly from Cairo.
I see you've met our charming host. Just pay no attention to anything he tells you.
How rude. Henry Wotton. Victoria, my wife. My aunt, alas, you know.
Oh, I'm so glad you've met you. Why learn some manners from this boy? Harry, I found some more guests for you to insult.
I knew I kept her for something. I do hope our paths cross again, Mr. Gray.
Thank you for the cigarette. Cigarette.
An acquired taste.
No, it's actually quite pleasant.
No, I meant Harry.
Some people I want you to meet.